Everyone, this is me, Sujit Kumar. I am your maths faculty, and I am now going to complete or means continue my next part in the vectors. But before starting my profile, this is me, Sujit Kumar, BTech in electrical, and 2 years of work experience in Tata Consultancy Services as assistant system engineer. Now, let's see, in the last lecture, we were understanding the addition of vectors, but we haven't formulated, means what is the formula with which we can get the resultant. So see, formula for magnitude can be received by getting the square root of the magnitude of first vector and second vector, then the twice of product with cosine of theta. So you should remember a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta, that's square root. Okay, and how has we received, or how have we received with the diagram that we have shown in the last class, you can check this. Okay, with this ad square is becoming with what, ab plus b ka whole square plus t square, and ab plus b is by getting the component or using the basic triangle, you know, sine and cosine in the means trigonometry, you can get the result. Okay, and the alpha that we were saying in the last class, the angle between the resultant vector and the remaining vector is, can be received also by this tangent of the alpha. Okay, tangent of alpha is what, d upon ae, and d is nothing but b sine theta, and a is nothing but a plus b cos theta. Through this, we are getting tangent of alpha, and by taking this inverse, we can get alpha, means alpha will be tan inverse b sine theta upon a plus b cos theta. So it is the formula that you need to learn by heart, because it will be useful in maths as well as in physics. Okay, as per my knowledge. Okay, and still it is going on, because every concept is related on the vector in the physics. And also there is mass portion in the 12th class, you will get to know in the 3D and vector, such concept is highly used. Okay, now let's move to the next. See, after understanding the question, sorry, after understanding the formula, now let's solve one basic problem. Okay, without solving the problem, we are unable to understand that what is going on. So let's check out the question. Two vectors having equal magnitude, okay, it means having the magnitude same, which is A, making an angle theta with each other. Okay, they are making an angle theta. Then what do we need to find? Find the magnitude and the direction of the resultant. It is asking the simple question, asking the magnitude as well as the direction. So can you solve? Okay, please pause the video and try to solve on your own self. Okay, otherwise after then I will solve it. Okay, it is quite basic question, I think. Because after solving problem, you will understand the concept much better. Never try to learn only theory in any subject, especially in maths. Okay, and then physics. After understanding the theory, you should solve some question. With this, you will get the proper knowledge. Okay, and it will remember in your mind. Okay. Let's see the solution. Magnitude of the resultant is what? As we have the formula, b is means resultant vector is b is first vector square, second vector square, and the product of the two vector twice with the cosine of theta, and we are taking the square root. So with this, we have got this 2a cos theta by 2. Okay, you can pause the video and you can note down the solution if you like. Okay, other if you have solved the solution, then very good, I am giving you the thumbs up. Okay, now the resultant will make but it is what, it is the magnitude. Now we need to find the angle also, because without the angle we cannot say that this is the vector. So, hence we need to find the angle also, and the tangent of alpha is nothing but the as you can use the formula, b sine theta means the first vector's sine, second vector's then cosine. So we have done this, and with this, by using some basic trigonometry, you can get the answer, which is alpha is getting y, what, theta by 2. Okay, see, so the resultant of the two equal vector bisects the angle between them. It is also a property. Okay, you can learn. If there are two equal vector, they will basically bisect. Okay, it becomes what? Angular bisector. Okay, in math you will know in the coordinate. Okay, angular bisector. Okay, if the two vectors are same. So from this you can understand. I hope you have understood something, and I think we should continue our lecture in the next time. Okay, for now, bye. Thank you.